Hi everybody, a very 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 good evening to you all, and I hope you all are doing good. You all are indoors and you all are safe, and I'm sure you are taking good precautions for yourself, and you all are perfectly fine, and I'm sure you all are doing good at home. And if you all are crafters, I know you all must be busy doing some crafting or the other sitting in this quarantine. It is one of the best time that we can actually get to do a lot of our work. It's a good peaceful time that you will get. So okay, now I could see a few people. Hi everybody. So today's live session is all about paper flower making, and which is the best paper that can be used to make your paper flower jewelry. So I'm sure you all of y'all have made some kind of, you know, flowers sometime or the other. I am not able to see the comments. Somehow I need to check maybe I can see it in the other phone. I'll just check it. Okay, now I could see the comments. Okay, I don't know, somehow I was not able to see the comments at all, but yes, at least now I can see a few people. Okay, I could see a lot of highs and hellos and very good evenings. Okay, so I'm sure you all are crafters, and today's session, I don't want to make it a very usual one, like the way, you know, I come, I show y'all see, y'all watch, you know, y'all love it, y'all enjoy it, and thereafter you all do make it. But this time I want you all also to participate with me. So I'll be asking you all a few questions. Let me also know what are your, you know, views on it, and what are your, basically comments for the same. So if you all are here and you all are into little bit some kind of flower making and all, I am sure you all are working with some kind of paper. So I want to know what all papers are you all using. And what do you all think? What are the papers that can be available at home and you can make flowers at any point of time? So right now we are in quarantine. So it, you know, we know that, you know, all the parcel services are closed off and we cannot see, we cannot receive any of the parcels. And, you know, it's getting a little difficult at this time right now. So from the time I have launched my course, I have been getting continuous inquiries for this floral jewelry making. Ma'am, we would love to learn it, we would love to do it, but ma'am, we don't have the papers, we need to order it. Can we make the same jewelry with the help of the paper available at home? So the big answer to that was yes, you can. So, and you know, we don't have the inks, or we don't have, you know, particular inks which you have been using. Somehow the comments have stopped coming. I don't know what is the issue in the screen. I will try to take another phone and I will reply to all your queries very soon. So somehow, I mean, the whole big question was to everyone was, which is the best paper that can be used? Which are the best inks? So finally I thought, okay, let me do a live session and let me talk to you all and let me also work on it. I know, and after I got a lot of queries from the students, I started working on this question. Okay, what can the students do? What exactly can they work with different papers, or, you know, what exactly can they do with different inks? So not that earlier we used to not use different color mediums. We did use different color mediums, but as we grow, as we learn more, we develop more and more new techniques and, you know, new ideas. So I can, okay, finally now again, some comments have started popping up. So I can see, okay, somebody said iris white cardstock, somebody said soft oriental paper, somebody said only cardstock. That is very nice. So when I put up this question, you can make your flowers just by using whatever papers you have at home. So what is the first thing that comes to our mind? What exactly is the first thing that comes to our mind is like, which is the best paper that you can use right now, what is available at home? Okay, so somebody says soft oriental, decage paper, handmade paper, iris paper, good. So you all are really pro with all these, you know, you all know good answers and you all are quite easy with this. So coming to the point, we have always made flowers with various papers since years. You know, we have been making flowers with normal regular papers, executive bond papers, plain papers, as we grew, we got into, you know, kind of handmade papers. And then, of course, pattern papers. I mean, I have rarely used. I don't remember when I have used pattern papers to create, because it is more for mixed media and scrapbooking. So we have not really touched that paper. But I will share today what all papers I have tried in the past 4-5 days and what are the best options that I can give it to you for all those who wish to join this course. So do you all want me to show you all first all my display and the jewelry, and then shall we go on to the working, or first you'll want to see the whole demo and then maybe we can, you know, go on to seeing. I would like to see some comments from you all. So what exactly you all want to do? Paper which is minimum around 120 GSM. Yes, that's good. That's nice. 160 GSM you have with you. Okay, which all papers do you all have with you in the current situation right now? Chart paper. Okay, that's good. You have chart paper. A4 paper. So those are the printer papers. First demo. Okay, fine. We'll go with the demo and maybe then I will show you all what I have to show you all. So for flower making, I have just noted down a few points, and those are a few very important points. The first step when it comes to flower making, the first thing that strikes all of us is the paper. After paper, next question is, what is the shape of the flower? After I go on to that shape of the flower, the third question comes in our mind, which colors am I going to use it? Then I go on to the next step, what are the embossing methods? After I finish all the embossing methods, the next question immediately comes to our mind is, what are the formation methods? Thereafter, immediately the next question comes is, what about the final arrangements? Where all can we use the papers? So these are a few 4 to 5 to 6 points that always come to our minds, to everybody. So what is the best way, you know, to go about this? So I'll go step by step and I'll show you all in detail how you can do a lot of work by yourself. And okay, many of you all have really wanting to see the display. Okay, I'll show you all the display because I am fresh. The display is fresh. Everything is fresh. And what you're going to learn, that I'm going to show you in the end. Because I'm sure you all are going to really love what I have made today. It is an, you know, 2 nights job that I have done. But I pat my back. I have done a good job to show you all what maximum I could do out of these two papers. I'll discuss about the papers also. So the first thing that I want to show you all is the new floral oriental. I have used the soft oriental paper from Dress My Craft. So, you know, I have created 3 different jewelries. One is that I'm wearing. And you all, I want to see it closely, how the jewelry looks. So this is how the jewelry looks. I hope it is a good clear vision for all of y'all. So this is one project. The other project I will show y'all. The other project is this. This is the second one. So in total, I have created 3 necklaces. So you can select any one necklace, or you can also select all the 3, or you can also select any 2. So you have your choices. This is the third one. So this is one necklace, and all my projects right now are with the soft oriental paper. I prefer a soft oriental paper. I'll come to the paper and, you know, voice is slow. Okay, maybe the phone was a bit far from me. Excuse me. I think now maybe you can hear me. So I've shown you all the 3 beautiful neck pieces which I have made out of it. And now if you guys want to see what I have created, oh, you could see it anyway. Y'all can see this. So these were the maximum possibilities that I can do. I did it without using the normal regular papers which we use. I'll take you all a little bit more closer and I will show you all what are all the possibilities that we can work on it. Apart from this, I have a few projects of a different paper, and that I'll come to it in the end. Maybe I will show you all that in the end. So I'll hang up my phone onto the camera stand and we start with our work, and I will quickly start giving you all a demo. I'm sure you all are, I hope this session is a stress buster for you all. Thank you so much. Okay. So can you all see the table? Yes, the table can be seen. Perfect. My voice is low. I have done a lot of hard work in the last 2 days. A lot of hard work for this live session. इतना तो स्कूल में और कॉलेज में भी पढ़ाई नहीं किया जितना ये सेशन के लिए पढ़ाई किया, बिकॉज देर वॉज लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च एंड आई एम हैप्पी विद द रिसर्च दैट आई हैव डन एंड आई होप आई एम एबल टू गिव यू ऑल सम गुड अमाउंट ऑफ नॉलेज दैट आई हैव गैदर्ड इन दीज 2 डेज. सो एज आई सेड, द फर्स्ट स्टेप दैट कम्स फॉर नाउ इज माई वॉइस क्लियर? कैन यू ऑल हियर मी क्लियरली? ओके. सो नाउ जस्ट अ फ्यू थिंग्स दैट आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस इज रिगार्डिंग द पेपर. द फर्स्ट थिंग, वॉट ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज शुड द पेपर हैव? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, फर्स्ट द पेपर शुड बी प्लायबल सो दैट इट बिकम्स वेरी इजी फॉर यू टू डू एनी काइंड ऑफ शेपिंग. सेकेंडली, द पेपर शुड एब्जॉर्ब कलर. आई वॉन्ट यू ऑल ऑल्सो टू पार्टिसिपेट एंड टेल मी वॉट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट वी लुक आउट इन अ पेपर वेन वी आर डूइंग ज्वेलरी मेकिंग. देर आर मेनी ओल्ड स्टूडेंट्स विच आई कैन सी हियर एंड आई एम श्योर दैट यू ऑल ऑल्सो कैन पार्टिसिपेट बिकॉज यू ऑल हैव रियली एक्सपीरियंसड इट वेरी वेल दैट वॉट आर द बेस्ट पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ द पेपर्स दैट वी रियली लुक फॉर वेन इट कम्स टू ज्वेलरी मेकिंग. सो फर्स्ट एज आई सेड, इट इज प्लाई, इट शुड बी प्लायबल. Secondly, I said it should be absorbing the color very well. Thirdly, the paper should be either white, preferably, or it can be off-white. Alka says soft. Yes, I agree to this point. The paper should be soft. It is very important. Color should merge. That means the paper should absorb the color well. Should hold the shape. Excellent. You guys are too good. I'm telling you, you guys are really answering me so well. And I've been able to now read all the comments that are popping up on the screen. So what are the more qualities that you see in the paper? Durable. Okay. Durability. Yes, to some extent. Paper doesn't fade. Very good, Shivani. This point is so perfect. So perfect. Amazing. Very nice. And you know, when you answer, there are so many people actually solving their problems, actually solving their queries. Paper should be waterproof. It is difficult. We have to make it waterproof. Papers generally do not come waterproof, but what we can do to make it waterproof? Yes, we can try and answer all those questions today. Oh my god, today is my exam. I have to answer so many questions and I have made a big question list for myself. Durable, yes, durability is good. Thickness is good, whether it is soft or thick, both I can say it is nice. Perfect. Stiffness for flower. So now, when I have always been doing my flower making, I have used many papers. I will come to that point also, which papers I have already used. But in these 2-3 days, what I could research is, the first thing, when we were kids, we used to do our drawing and coloring on a cute small drawing book. And that drawing book is the cartridge drawing book. I'm sure we all know. Okay, I'm still getting the answers. Quick drying. This is also a good point, Bharti ji. This is a good point. It should be quick drying. I wish I would have told you all to keep a paper and a pencil handy so you all could also track the notes. Flexibility of the paper, pliability of the paper, yes, it's all fast drying, yes, quick drying, fast drying, all are the common points. So we all have used cartridge drawing book, right, at some point. So these are cartridge sheets, but the one that you get in the school books are little, sometimes not of a very good quality. You also get cartridge sheets separately in the market. So which we can use, the reason being, when the children are going to color on this, the color is going to stay on it. That means this paper has color absorbency. Now how much it is thin, how much it is thick, how much it is pliable, that you will come to know only when you experiment. Until and unless you do not experiment, you do not come to know how the paper is. Then what paper I had at home, the second option which I saw, is the same cartridge book, but it had written something like, you know, a TK sheet over it. So as a college student, being a textile designer, I know that what are TK cartridge sheets. TK cartridge is a combination of TK and cartridge, wherein you also get a TK sheet separately. All the students who have done interior designing, fashion designing, architecture, they have all done their drawings on these TK sheets. TK sheets you get in two qualities. One is Indian TK, one is Japan TK. So I will write it here so you guys know. One is Indian TK, one is Japan TK. Japan TK is expensive and it is of a more superior quality. And earlier one, the first one we discussed was cartridge. So these are the three papers which I could think of. Still, I hunted into my, you know, paper stack areas. I did get some cardstocks, but I have also listed cardstock in my list. Then I also found one book. TK sheet is the name of a paper. I genuinely do not know the full form of it, but I know we have used TK sheets in our college time. We have used TK sheets for drawings. I have a few samples of TK sheets. I will show it to you. And they come in different gradations. Then I found one more thing, that was a sketching paper. This particular medium really interested me because the minute it is sketching, it is absorbing charcoals, it is absorbing pencils, it is also going to absorb some kind of color pencils. That means this paper has got some color absorbency. TK sheets, I'll show you all. I'm just going step by step. TK full word, full form, I really do not know. But I know there are TK sheets and they are available in the market. And you will get it only in those stores which actually sell, you know, kind of to the students of college who are into engineering or any kind of, you know, fashion designing or architectures or interior designing. So when I saw these sketching sheets, I really found them superb and they are really good. And I have tried flowers with this. And if you see, it is, you know, from Fabriano company. Another best paper that I found was with the same Fabriano. This was watercolor paper. But the watercolor paper, I had 300 GSM. So I did not try it out at all because 300 GSM is too thick for flower making. It's not really very practical to do it. After this, I will show you all the TK sheet. I need a help from somebody to get it from inside, or I hope I have kept a sheet inside here. Let me check if I have a sheet inside. It's just a plain white sheet, like a normal cartridge sheet. So if I have to open this book only and show you, these are my actually old notes. I hope one page is empty in this to show you all. Okay, I could see one page empty here. So this is a plain white sheet. Unless you do not use it, you will not come to know that, you know, it is just a plain white paper. So after exploring all these mediums, I have tried to make flowers with the cartridge sheet. I have tried to make flowers with the Fabriano sketching paper. These were the two best papers which I found in my stash to do it. Watercolors would have worked, but watercolors has its drawbacks also. So the flowers I'll show you, which I have created using the TK sheet and using the cartridge sheet and using the sketching paper. But before I move on to showing you all the demo, it'll be just a very quick demo. After this, we have selected the paper. Do you all have any other papers in your mind other than this? Fabriano is a water absorbent and it's a good color. It's a good paper. It is a very good paper. Fabriano is available in only good stores which they show on the paper. Otherwise, Fabriano is not locally very easily available. It is smooth also, it is grained also. So for flower making, we also need a smooth paper. Too much of a texture may also look good sometimes, it may not look good. One paper which we all have forgotten to mention, as per me, is handmade. Handmade papers are also very good to make your flowers. They are too good. To some extent, I can write pattern papers. Although this fact is considered for scrapbooking and your mixed media. Yes, you can make out of newspapers, you can make out of tissue papers, you can also make out of corrugated sheets. Those are all best out of waste. but yes, you can make some good flowers out of it. Secondly, how are you going to select your shape? The most important thing is selecting your shape. If I am going to hand cut it, then how am I going to start drawing my drawings? So the best thing what I derived is, if I take a straight line like this and I go on to basic shapes, let the basic shapes be, you know, a circle. Example, if I divide the circle into two, then I have a square, then I have a teardrop, then I have a heart shape, then I have a leaf kind of a pointed shape, then I have some curve kind of a shape. So these are the basic shapes which come to my mind when I think of flower making. So when I think, okay, what are the maximum possibilities that I am going to draw and how are the best ways I am going to draw on any of these papers. So what I have done is, after getting onto these basic shapes, my circle can be elongated, my circle can be a little broad, my teardrop can be sleek, my teardrop can be flattened from the top, the heart shape can be, you know, little pointed, the heart shape can have a little bit of a wave, the heart shape can have way less of a wave, the height of the heart shape can be lesser. The pointed shape that I have done, there can be different shapes into this. If I have kind of an S, sometimes I just have a smooth curve. So these are the various shapes that come to my mind and how am I going to plot it on the paper? How am I going to create my templates? Yes, that's a good thing. Somebody said templates. Yes, you can draw your own templates. You can trace it and you can do it. But if you have to do something freehand, if you have to do something on your own, how are you going to do your hand cutting also of the flowers? So the best way is pick up any one basic shape. For example, for all those who want to do hand cut flowers, this is the best tip for you all. People like me are lazy, who don't want to do too much of a hand cutting, for the simple reason, I love it, but we have so much of work, it's really not practical. I'll be very happy to cut for 10 flowers. I'll be jumping out of joy to cut for 20 flowers. But the day I get an order for 100 flowers, I'll run to a craft store to buy the die cutting machine and the die. Because as the quantity grows, the possibilities become less of hand cutting. That is what I personally understand. So now, if I have a simple circle, let's say I have a plain circle. In the first point, I will divide the circle into some equal parts. What are those equal parts? Either I divide my circle into four parts, or I divide my circle into six parts, or I will divide my circle into eight parts. So the best way to create your own shapes is, in the first step, give a slit at 12 o'clock. Don't go in too much deep till the center. Just go in a little bit, you know, less. Then exactly on the opposite side, you go on 6 o'clock and you go, you know, almost a quarter of an inch. Thereafter, I cut a slit at 3 a.m. and then a slit at 9 a.m. So I have divided my circle into four parts. That means I have a four petal flower. And how am I going to shape it? It's very easy, very simple. From the edges, I will turn it on one side. From the other side, I will turn it on one side. First, I finish cutting everything on my right. Then I'll flip over and I'll go on the left. So these are loads of shapes which are endless. You can do it, creating your different flowers as you wish. This is the first thing where you need a four petal flower. Now, in case you need a three petal flower, there is some technical mistake. I cannot see the comments. I don't know why. What is the problem today? I just don't know. Let me try to check. I'll ask somebody to check it for me, but I'm not able to read the comments today. So these are divided into four parts. If I have to further divide it into 6 parts or 8 parts, it really becomes a little difficult for us. So what you do, you take a template like this, take a printout of a circle and create, you know, this pattern. So what will happen, this pattern will help you to give your key points perfectly and you will be able to create, you know, 6 parts, 8 parts or 10 parts, whatever number of parts you want, and then you will be able to cut your different shapes. So what you do is, in the first place, you place your circle right in the center. Let us give 4 opposite points, you know. Say for example, I have 1, I have 2. I'm going to divide the circle into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I can take alternate. So this is one best way to mark your points. Especially if you have kids and you really are looking for teaching the kids and something that is economical for their pockets, then this technique is wonderful. I don't believe in folding the paper, because the minute you fold the paper, you get a crease line, and then it is so difficult to remove that crease line which falls in the folded paper. So I have done my marking. Of course, I will erase it if it is going to be seen. And now what I will do is, I will further cut it down. And please note, don't go in too much till the center. And the most important point, when I cut, my this point should face this point. So when I cut, my angle of the scissors cannot go left, cannot go right. It has to be perfect 90 degrees straight up. So that is way you will get a very, very perfect cutting. If you go a little tilted, no problem. It's a hand cutting flower, so it's fine. But generally, it is good if you do not go too tilted. Otherwise, you will lose the uniformity of the petals. So now I have divided my circle into 8 parts. So I am going to create a beautiful flower with 8 equal parts. Correct? I think I have missed a cut here. Okay. So now what I will do is, I want to shape this. So what I will, how I'm going to shape it is, if I want a teardrop, I will start from the center and I will cut it. While cutting, fussy cutting, this kind of detail cutting is very important. One thing I want to show you all is, never take a scissor and prick it like this till the end. You'll spoil the end or the sharpness. You know, the paper will get a slit and this will eventually, you know, really spoil it. So what you will have to do is, take the width of your scissor and make sure that you move the paper. Do not move your scissor. So you will get a very nice and a uniform and a very beautiful, any kind of wavy cut or fussy cutting will become very easy. So this is how you are going to create your different shapes. I won't go too much in detail now. I'll move on to the next step, because I have a lot of things to show today. And this is just a very simple small thing that I've tried to show you all, that, you know, in a very simple manner and in a very easy manner, you can hand cut your flowers. And if you need some inspirations, you have Pinterest, and I have taken out some die cutouts. I have not done any hand cutting, of course. I can't hear you. You can't hear me, girls? Because no doubt my screen is still. I am not able to read any comments. I hope I'm audible. If somebody says yes, I'll be really, very happy. And I'm taking the help of the second phone to check my comments also. So can you see, this is a 4 petal flower. I'll take a contrast color base to show it to you all. This is a 4 petal. These are not hand cut, these are die cut, but just for reference and shape purposes, I am showing it to you so that you know what I'm trying to talk. So these are perfect, you know, 4 petal flowers. Say if I have just 3 petal flower, then this is it. So this is how you can go on taking some inspirations from the net, and you can go on creating your shapes, your own hand cut shapes, for all those who do not want to die cut. It is really, you know, I mean, it will be very easy for you. If you take some references, you will be able to get beautiful shapes. So this is the 3 petal shape. So this is how you can easily cut different shapes. So I have points, I have rounds, I have hearts, I have kind of, you know, leaf shapes. So this is how you can do your hand cutting. For lots of people who are asking me, ma'am, I don't have a machine, I don't want to invest on the dies, then you can hand cut your pieces in this method. After this hand cutting is over, the most important part comes is the selecting of the colors. So what are the best colors that I can use for my flower making? For flower making, I am going to show you all different color mediums. We all are quite well versed with distressings, which is, you know, kind of, you can say, latest. I mean, for the last 7-8 years we have been using this. Apart from distressings, you can also use your archival inks. Apart from archival inks, you can also use your pencil colors. Pencil colors, and I have watercolor pencil colors. So this is water pencil color, so they are nice. Then you can also use your watercolors. You can also use your soft pastels, but you cannot use your oil pastels. That will become too patchy and all that stuff, you know. So the best mediums which I like is watercolors or pencil colors or soft pastels. And to be very honest, I am totally hooked on to distressings and archival inks, because it is very easy to spread, very fast to spread, and it is really very, 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 you know, the colors are too good. You don't have to blend any two colors to get those certain shades. What shades distress inks have and what shades archival inks have, it's difficult to get in the others, but it is not just not, I mean, difficult. It is easy to create your beautiful all other things. I will quickly give you all a demo of using all these three mediums at least today, so that you all know how does a watercolor pencil work, how does a distress ink work, and how does a soft pastel work. After the color mediums, the most important part comes in selecting photocolors. Yes, you can use photocolors. I could read the comments now. Re-inkers also you can use. Photocolors also you can use. Yeah, what I had in my tray was Staedtler's. So soft pastels can also be used. Now with the color mediums, what comes the most important is the color theory. What I see many a times, if you are passing by, you know, and you are doing a window shopping, you see something really attracts you. Why? What is the first major reason why it attracts you? Is the color. So you go close to that particular subject, and then when you go still more closer, you will see it's more detailed things. So how does that happen? This is all and all and only because of colors. Colors play a very, very, very important role when you are going to do your coloring. So, you know, these are my college assignments, and I felt this was the best time to show y'all, because never we ever get a chance to get into the basics of all these things. We always come, we show you the demo of the products that we are using, and we do not get into much details. But overall, I have seen, next time, whenever if I get a chance, I will get into these details more. But right now, I will quickly flip over to all this also. So I'm sure we all know what is a color wheel. We all know what are warm colors. We all know what are cool colors. We all know what are primary colors. We all know what are secondary colors. So whenever you are creating any arrangement, you have to follow this. If you follow this, I am sure you are really going to do wonders. So this is the basic color wheel, and I hope in the screen you can see the whole thing. So far I'm not able to see the whole thing, but I'm sure you all can see the whole thing. So here, you know, this is how is the basic color wheel. After the basic color wheel, I want to show you all the warm colors and the cool colors. So can you see, these are the warm colors. So when you are doing an arrangement, you try to pick up the colors which go into warm family, or you pick up the colors that go into the cool family. The minute you follow this, it is going to be, your work is 70% ready. You are 70% pass the minute you follow the color scheme. I mean, check my words, the day you start following all this, you will have easy way to get your colors. Many times I see certain works, and I'm a little okay, you know, these people really need some color basic knowledge, and it is really very important. Then comes the most important part, is the tints and the shades. So what are the tints and the shades? This is the central line, which is neutral. This is my original color line. So when I go on adding white, I go on getting the tints. When I go on adding the dark, that is the black, I go on getting the shades. So, you know, if you follow this, if I take this light pink and all of a sudden I take this orange, the entire arrangement is going to be imbalanced. So if I'm taking this pink, I must follow this, and I should follow this whole line. If I am taking this pink, then I must follow this peach. If I use this red, then I must go with this green and this orange family. Then if I use something else, then the entire arrangement goes imbalanced. So colors play a very, very, very important role. So these are a few exercises in, you know, complementary, double split. This is too much in detail, but basic also, if you follow, it is more than enough. Now, this is known intensity of changing value. It is exactly the same as what I said about the tones and the tints and the shades. I'm sure this lessons could be a little bit boring for a few of y'all, but I felt today let me cover up all the basics for entire color theory. So, you know, once and for all, if somebody is asking me, I can tell them, okay, you go to this live session and you can really watch it. Trust me, we are right now in quarantine. If you follow these basic things, and today if you are going to take my live session a little bit more seriously and you make your samples, do your experiments and keep filling your boxes, end of the session I'm going to show you my 10 to 12 boxes, all fill up whenever we have extra time and we keep making these samples for ourselves. So you can you see, just tell me one thing very honestly, out of these 6 boxes, which is the box that you really like the most? I'll number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I will wait for you all to reply. I really want to know from you all, of the 6 boxes, which is the box which appeals to you the most? I'm just waiting for a few answers. So before I move on, there is a reason behind this, and I want to answer this question. You like number 3? So many of you all like number 3. Number 2 is liked by many of you all. Is 1 coming in between the comments that you all are not liking 1? Or shall I turn it upside down? So 2 is a good choice. 3 is also a good choice. None of you all are liking 4, 5 and 6 because they are dark. If you play with dark colors, you must have a contrast. If you do not have a contrast, it will not look good. So it is very, very, very important to play in the family of the colors. So if I show you 1 a bit more closely, I love 1 personally. The lighter the tone, the higher the value. The darker the tone, the lesser the value. That is what the color theory says. No doubt, a personal choice always matters. But you always note one thing, whenever you do any kind of work, you notice it, you will understand what I am trying to say. So thanks, I have got my answers. So I know what is the average choice everybody has. Okay, these are the color schemes. These are too much in detail, but I just want to say y'all one thing from this. Monochromatic. Try to follow a monochromatic, means one color with different tones and shades, so you can create a wonderful arrangement. Okay, the complementary colors came in the end, but that's fine. You can see, the minute you make a beautiful rose and you underneath put a green leaf, your arrangement looks awesome. The minute you get into some kind of violets and yellows, you will see a beautiful arrangement. So this is how the whole complementary colors are there. So these are, you know, darks and lights, tints and tones added to the complementary colors. So this is how you can see the tonal values and how you can balance it. Color theory is very deep. If you get into it, you will really work wonders on your projects. Color key. This is one color. I am adding whites to it and I am adding blacks to it. So can you see how beautiful this exercise is, which was given to us? I hope you all are not reading the marks. There are marks in the bottom. These were the marks they were given by the teachers to us. So average, I have got 6 and 7 in all. So, you know, these are all the keys and this is how you can go about your working. This was just a design which we had to do. Now comes the most important part. This was our homework. Every week compulsory, we had to submit 4 charts creating your own shades with the colors which were left out in the palettes. So whatever color is left out in your palette, first you place that color, you know what colors you have mixed, what percentage you have mixed, then go on doing plus minus or whatever colors are left out. This will start developing color sense. By doing these, I will show you, right now I have only 4, I have tons of it, but I have just taken out 4 because I didn't want to get into much. So you know, this was my exercise and this is how you all also, you know, do little whenever you have time. Especially if you have time in this quarantine, you can really make your own color charts. So this is how you can create beautiful things. So we have covered up so far the papers, we have covered up selecting the shapes, we have done hand cutting, we have also almost through the color themes and the color theory. Now is, you know, kind of the next session which I will take up is selecting the embossing techniques, which I will give you a quick demo only for the embossing techniques, the formation of the flowers and the arrangement. Now I will come on to my practical demo so that you will understand better. I just need to wipe my hands quickly for the demo. I was from Nirmala Niketan College from Churchgate in Mumbai. I have done my textile designing course. So actually, I never did anything into textiles, but this course has really helped me grow very well in some form or the other. Fine. Now let me cut out. Let me show you all the cutouts which I have done. I haven't done hand cutting. I have done die cutting because really in this quarantine, we really don't have that much time to get into the hand cutting part. So whatever maximum I could do using these different papers, I have done it for you. So these are a few die cutouts from the sketching paper. These are a few die cutouts from the cartridge paper. And these are a few die cutouts from the Japan TK paper. So I have three papers right now over here. And in all the three pieces, I will show you how the coloring works. And I will give you a nice basic conclusion of how you can select the right paper and the right work. So these are also some few, you know, cardstock cutouts which I had done just to show you all. If you have a plain cardstock and you are coloring it like this, so how are you going to create your flowers out of it? I have made some flowers from cardstock also to show you all. So let me check where are they. My table is today flooded, so I need to check it. So these are all the cardstocks. These are plain papers. If all the old students are here, around 10-12 years back, or even 7-8 years back, we all did punch craft. So we used to get these, you know, kind of executive bond sheets which were colored. And we used to use these colored papers, and they are very pretty thin. They are hardly 70 to 80 GSM, or they are hardly, you know, 100 GSM. So you can actually even use these colored papers. How you can use it and how you can make the best advantage of it, I will show it to you. So let's get started first showing you the first thing. Let me get started is with the cartridge sheet. This is just a small demo. I will only make one petal. I don't want to get into making 10 petals, and I will just show you a small method of embossing it also equally together. And in the end, maybe if time permits, or in the end, I will show you one arrangement of whatever flowers I have. I may not have the same flowers, but I will show you all where I have used these flowers. So when I have taken these cartridge sheets, I am going to take distressings. They are the best. With the cartridge sheets, I can also use pencil colors. I will show you that also. And along with the cartridge sheets, you can also do soft pastels, but I would prefer soft pastels on the sketching paper. See, every paper will demand a different medium. Every paper will demand it will have a different reaction to different medium. Every paper will not be able to accept the embossing. Every paper will not be able to hold the petal stiff by itself. So it is very important to, you know, get the right paper. To give it in one small sentence to you all, I have made all my projects with the Soft Oriental Collection. Soft Oriental Collection paper, Floral Soft Oriental Collection paper from Dressmycraft, it has got all the properties. That means such a heavy research has been done on this paper. After doing a lot of trials and samples, we have come to a conclusion that this paper, or example, whatever next paper, is fitting into all the qualities. All the papers cannot have all the qualities. It is very rarely that one paper absorbs all the colors. I will do another live session showing you all the color mediums with the Soft Oriental Collection. Okay, so now you all know that the distressings are water-based, right? So if I apply ink and if I'm going to dip it in water, the entire ink is going to bleed out. So what am I going to do? How am I going to do my embossing? Otherwise, it is not going to be possible. So if you see this flower, I have made it from the cartridge paper. Of course, this is not of a very good GSM. This is a little local only. You get good qualities in cartridge sheets as well. So this is something, whatever I had at home, I have used it. And I have done the scrunching method. And one or two, I have done the embossing method. I will show you both. But I can show you with one scrunching method what wonders you can do and how beautifully you can create your flowers. So first of all, I take my distressings. I have taken, you know, any two shades. Say distressing, you know, the dried marigold and one lipstick. Soft pastels can be used on the oriental paper, yes. The GSM of the oriental paper, there are two. One is 120 and the other is 285, if I'm not mistaken. I also need to check. I use more of 120. Now, I take dried marigold and I have taken one lipstick. What I will do is, this paper, when I tried to emboss it, when it was the way it is, that is dry or hard, It didn't give me a good embossing. The paper crumpled, the paper got cracks, and the paper did not accept the embossing so well. So what I did, I just tried to dip this thin paper in water and I tried to emboss it first without using any inks. Thereafter, when I saw, okay, this paper is giving a good embossing technique after it was dipped in water, then what about the color? Color became a big question mark, you know, because once you, either I use archival inks, but now other than archival inks, what are the other mediums that you can be used? So first thing what you do is dip the paper in water, say for around 3 to 4 seconds. And today I have taken a towel. The reason being I am in short of dry tissues. I am just left with last half box and I didn't want to put that. So today I have taken a napkin. You can also use a napkin and you can also use the dry tissues. Alternative of pollens. Yes, Shreya, you have asked me a very good question, which even I haven't put it up in my notes, but I will definitely answer this. You can make homemade pollens. There are plenty of tutorials on YouTube how to make stamens at home. So you can really make beautiful stamens at home. Little bit what I know, I will share with you. Once I remove the paper from water, I will press it in the napkin and I'll make sure that the paper is light wet. It shouldn't dry completely. While it is wet, I immediately take the distress inks and I apply on almost half the petals, and I will apply this on the front and the back both. Right? I'm making sure that my petal is semi wet. It shouldn't be completely dry. Today's session is very theoretical and a lot of technical also. Are you all enjoying? Okay. Now, once I have finished this, I just forgot to deep cut it, girls. I will do it right now quickly. A deep cutting is a mix must on the petals when it comes. So I'm taking my scissor and I'm cutting this petal from the center on from both the sides so that, you know, I just forgot to do the fussy cutting. So your scissor must face the center of the opposite petal to get perfect uniform. First do deep cutting. Then you dip the petals in water and then you go about further. This shouldn't dry because the paper is so thin, it will dry quickly. Then you can take any embossing tools or you can take any pencil or pen, whatever you have with you. Wrap around this one petal, around this. Make sure you hold the center of the petal and the outer end of the petal. Scrunch it in the center first and then scrunch it down. After you scrunch it, you go down also. You did good nails, and nails are all broken right now in quarantine. So it's a little difficult, but I'll manage it. First, scrunch it on the wider area, and this has to be done while the petals are wet. This cannot be done once it gets dried. So this is how we complete scrunching. I'll leave one petal and show you how to do the embossing. For embossing, you can either use the embossing pad. This was the Pergamon embossing pad, or you can use your old diary. Somebody was asking me that, you know, if I don't have an embossing pad, if I don't have a perforating pad, then what do I do? So you can use any kind of sponge available in the house. You can take cosmetic sponges, you can take kitchen sponges, or anything, you know, you can use it. So if I have to do embossing on this, I'm taking this soft, this embossing pad, I'm taking the ball tool, and from the top I will come giving lines. So this is one form of embossing, of giving straight lines. I will continue with more embossing with the further petals, so you know what are the different embossing techniques as well. So what happens is you will get straight lines. So this is one way of embossing your any kind of petals. Many times I get teared paper in this crunchy method. Then you need a lot of practice. 100% with practice you will get the result. So after this, I will take the next paper. Okay, did you see this? How it's looking? Now the scrunching is done and the petals are closed. I will gently open them so that the flower takes its little shape back and it looks very nice and natural. So this is how the petal looks when you are using your cartridge sheet. Cartridge sheet is quite thin, so please be a little careful if you are going to use your cartridge sheets. After this, I will take my sketching paper. So this is my sketching paper. With the sketching paper also, I have done the same method, but I will show you all how to use color pencils. So the best way to use the color pencils is first color. Color pencils won't be washed out completely. They will remain still little bit. So I will take a pink, I will take a little bit of a green, and I will take a light pink. This white tool is the Martha Stewart embossing tools. So these are Martha Stewart embossing tools. You will get them at crafterscorner.in. I think the GSM of the cartridge sheet is hardly 100. I don't see it much. Well, nothing is written on the book. I need to check, but it is hardly anything. Now I take this color pencils and I go from the center bottom. You all can create wonders with color pencils when you are not going to dip all this in water. From the top, I come down because the strokes that fall down should blend with the green color. Otherwise, it may not look good. I am giving you all a very basic shading. I am not getting into too much, but I am just trying to show you how the color pencils work. So this is how you will do your coloring with the color pencils. This is the Pergamano company embossing pad. This is different embossing pad. What we are using these days is this. I'll come to this also, which one it is, the embossing and the perforating pad both. So the major difference between the embossing pad and the perforating pad is the embossing pad is soft, the black ones which I showed right now. And the perforating pad is harder. So the perforating, the word by itself means to prick holes, you know, to give holes. So when we have to give holes to the center petals and we prick them with the needles, we use the perforating pad so that you do not spoil the embossing pad. Embossing pad is good to use the soft one depending upon the paper. You have to choose the embossing pad as well. I will do a shortcut and I will not color the back, so that I move on to the next step after this. These are watercolor pencils. I had some tiny flowers here with me and I'm not able to find it. I had some tiny flowers. Oh, here they are very much next to me. I'll show it to you. And I had colored these tiny daisies with the color pencils and they look so gorgeous. Yeah, these are Staedtlers. What I'm using right now is Staedtlers. Right? So now what I'll do is, I either dry emboss it or I'll be misting it little with the mist, mini mister, so that I don't dip it too much in the water. So what I'll do is very mildly I will mist it. Can you see the color start bleeding? Once you see the color start bleeding, take a brush, help it to blend. Because these are watercolor pencils. So this acts like a watercolor medium. And now I'll just press this quickly into the napkin. So for this, the embossing can also be done on the embossing pad or even on the perforating pad. You can do the embossing. If the paper is extra thin, then you can use a harder base. if the paper is also soft and the embossing pad is also extra soft, then it will become a little difficult. So if it is a harder base, it will bounce back. Can you see? I can create beautiful lines. I can just create beautiful lines, and it's, you know, going like butter. They are just moving out like butter. So either you give your straight lines or your curvy lines, or you just do an outline to your petal. This is one way of doing your embossing. So different shapes will demand different embossing, and you can try with one shape all the five embossing techniques, different. You yourself will come to know what is looking good. Either you can also use the groove tools. These are groove golf tools. I had a question, if I don't have the groove tools, then you use the ball embossing tools and you give that many number of lines, that also fine. But groove golf tools work the best and they give you wonderful shapes. Like this. These are stainless steel groove golf tools from Dress My Craft, and they are available in 4 to 5 sizes, if I'm not mistaken. So this is how you can use your groove golf tools. Anything else? I think the basic cupping I can show you with the big ball tool. So if I'm using a big ball tool, then I don't need the hard sponge, then I need the soft sponge. So depending upon the technique also you are doing, you need to keep changing your sponge. Either you need a soft, or you need a hard, or you need this pergamino. So this is how, and then you in the end press it in the center like this. So I can see some lines. If I have to take it a little closer, these are straight lines. These are straight lines. This is just an outer line. Here is the groove golf tool. Here is the groove golf tool. And here is the plain embossing. So these are different embossing methods that you can follow. Now I will show you all quickly with the TK sheet. So let me take a TK sheet. I think this is okay. Okay, let me take this. This shape is also fine for a TK sheet. This is also a very interesting shape. Now I won't forget, and I will show you the deep cutting. Make sure you deep cut from both the sides so that no paper is left out. So this is first step. What you can do is deep cutting. So once I have finished this, I'll show you how to color it with the soft pastels. And when we use soft pastels, we do not wet the paper. We do a dry embossing. We cannot do wet embossing. If you say paper water mein dalte hi fat jata hai, if that is what you have written in Hindi, then we need to check which paper you are talking about. Okay, so I have this. Either you use the cotton buds or you use your hands to spread colors on this with the help of soft pastels. Let me take a yellow and start rubbing. Superb. The TK sheets, the cartridge sheets, all these will take up the colors. But once again, all have their limitations. All have their individual limitations. So once I'm done with the yellow, I won't do on the back, I will just do on the front. As I said, I'm going a little shortcut. From the top, I will gently blend it. Shivani, foam pieces will work, but foam pieces depends kya soft hai, kitna hard hai. You will have to try getting it from the market. Foam pieces do work. Chart paper I really don't prefer because chart paper cracks. It shows cracky. 99%, even if chart paper, I know as a child when we used to do all our drawings in the school, the chart paper was not very good with the poster colors also. It used to wobble. See, selecting the paper is very important. Just because something is very, I understand that something is very easily available or something. But if you want a real good look to your flowers, then you must have, you know, perfect material. It is very, very, very important. Otherwise, you may not get the results. You know, you're struggling. Before even I go to final formation of this flower, I will show you two flowers. And I'll ask you all only tell me how are those flowers looking. So what I'm trying to say is, just understand what I'm talking is the variations. How can I give a natural look? For example, if I have a chrysanthemum flower. If I make a chrysanthemum flower with a cartridge sheet, if I make a chrysanthemum flower with your TK sheet, if I make a chrysanthemum flower with a soft oriental paper, or if I make a chrysanthemum flower with, you know, any handmade paper, or somebody said easy peasy paper. So all the four papers will give different look. The feel of the papers is different and the look to it also really matters. So as I said, we need to do dry embossing to this. So you can use your ball tool. You can take a bigger size of ball tool and you can simply give one line in the center. So you give one single line in the center. Can you see how different variating embossing methods will give you different results? Amazing. Different techniques, different results. To add on to this, if I tip twist the petal, then you see the entire look changes with the tweezer. Since we all have some extra time right now, you can, you know, start hand cutting your flowers. You can start coloring your flowers. You can start shaping your flowers and keep collecting them in your boxes. So whenever you need it in emergency, you can use them. So can you see how pretty the simple flower looks with a soft pastel? Nothing much to be done and it is so easy and so smooth. Now, I wanted to show you all the two flowers that I was talking about right now. Since we have done these three petals, I want to show you all what are the differences. For example, if I show you this tray, and if I show you, say for example, let me show you a peony. See this peony. Same peony made in different flowers will give you different results. But we will like certain effects with certain papers only. We will not like the same peony in different other papers. Is it clear? By the way, I mean, by then it comes on my screen, it's like a little late and I feel I'm talking a little earlier to y'all. Then when I get into carnations, okay, I'll try to lift my tray only. I think now I'm quite, you know, uniform. For example, hi Shalini, you are here. Oh, you see, your 1 hour is over because of Instagram. I'm so happy to see you. I'm really very happy to see you here. Next time, we'll do it together. We'll try something on FB. So this is carnation. Can you see how beautiful this carnation is looking? You know, there are certain papers which give you different certain results. Also, I will show you a chrysanthemum. What I'm trying to explain is the difference of papers. The minute the papers are different, the looks changes. I will show you all a few more projects so you understand what I'm trying to say is the different. Can you see how stiff these petals are or how they are and how natural the flowers look? See, there is always a difference when you are going to see. Chrysanthemum to bana liya, carnation to bana liya, rose to bana liya, but how beautiful it looks, it is up to us. These were my trials. Let me tell you, these are my trials. These are my trials and I don't really get away from this because I really do a lot of hard work on my trials and I'm telling you, sometimes you feel you're banging your head against the wall because you're not able to get certain results, but everything comes with a practice and I trial. I'll show you one more box. Now, can you see this? What is the difference? Did you find these? How different did you find this from that? Okay, let me show you a comparison of filler flower to a filler flower. And let me give you a comparison of a big flower to a big flower. That will be easy for you to answer. I have one more box. See, there is a reason why I'm showing you this. I want you all to understand that every paper will act different in every way. I hope I can keep two boxes near to each other and you can see it on the screen. See, one is on the right is a different paper and on the left is a different paper. So if you are in a quarantine and you are all at home right now, having plenty of time and having whatever papers at home, start your trials by tomorrow. Don't waste your time. Try your colors, try your papers, try your hand cutting, create your own shapes, create your own embossing techniques, and start working. Don't waste time. The day you have these boxes full, I'm sure when you get orders, you'll be really, really very happy. The big box is a different paper, and the small box is a different paper. These are looking extremely light and, a little bit, very, very, very kind of a little, you can say, vintagey. But if you see this, this is looking pretty nice and bright. So this is the soft oriental paper. If you notice, can you see this paper has absorbed the archival inks? In this, I have three mediums. I have archival inks, I have a distress ink, and I also have the soft pastels. So as somebody said when we discussed in the beginning, what are the properties of the paper that you really need? So the properties of the paper that you need is the color should not fade. The paper should be, the stiff or the flower should be stiff. I wish I get my paper in which I had written so I can explain you what I'm talking about. The points that we discussed in the starting, the paper should be pliable. Yes, the paper is pliable. The paper should absorb color. Yes, this paper is absorbing color. Is the paper white or off-white? Yes. Is it soft and thick? Both is there. It should hold shape? Yes. If you see these fillers very closely, all the petals are holding shape. This is made around 4 to 5 months back. This is not that I have made it recently. Then, is it quick drying? Yes, it dries quick. Is it, durable? Yes, it is durable. Is it smooth? It is smooth. So these are the properties that, very rarely it is to be found in one paper. So it is very, very important to select your right paper. Not that you cannot work with the other papers, you can. Your trials and experiments are going to give you the perfect answers. I was talking in between about those tiny flowers which I had done with the watercolor pencils, and I want to show it to you all. That to what level you can use one color medium and one paper. This was iris paper, and these are tiny, cute little daisies. The center is shaded with a yellow color pencil, and the outline is given with a blue color pencil. So I have just done dry embossing to this, but can you see how beautifully every medium is going to give you different result and how cute and, beautifully you can make the flowers. So this is how you can make beautiful flowers with your color mediums. Hi Nannu, you are there? How are you? Hello. Okay. Now I want to show you one more thing with the scrunching method. I want you all to guess. See this. This is what we do when we have little time and extra time basically. So these are calyxes. This is soft oriental paper which I have given single shade and I have done scrunching to it and I have kept it ready. Basically, I have created calyx with 3 petal, 4 petal, 5 petal. And whenever it is needed and you are in emergency and quickly you want to do something, these are raw work. These are the background works, the fillers, the calyxes, the leaves. I have forgotten to bring my leaf box. If somebody can help me bringing my big leaf box from my room, I will show you. कि जब तक आप एक्स्ट्रा काम नहीं करोगे, आई एम नॉट सेइंग आप डब्बे भरो इतने, बट एटलीस्ट डू समथिंग वेन एवर यू आर आइडल, डोंट वेस्ट टाइम, एटलीस्ट मेक समथिंग. द मोर यू वर्क, द मोर यू आर गोइंग टू गेट आउट ऑफ इट. आई हैव अ फ्यू लीव्स विच आर अराउंड 7 to 8 ईयर ओल्ड. दे आर नॉट अभी का बना हुआ. दीज वर द प्लेन पेपर, कैन यू सी? एंड लॉट ऑफ पेंसिल कलरिंग इज डन इन टू इट. So how you can use your paper and your color mediums to create your work. So what I'm trying to say is you can use lots of paper mediums, you can use lots of color mediums, you can use lots of different types of paper and create. It's all that you have to try. the more you try, the more work you will get. I hope I can get to show you all some other paper. Okay, I can show you one thing. This was the leaf and we cut it into this. So how you are going to reshape your leaves is also very important. If I have a die cut out of this, I want to show you. This is the punch. These are the Jeff punches. Can you see? This is the leaf and we have actually trimmed it and we have done some extra deep cutting into this. Let me keep it on the black base so it will become easier for you all to see. So how you are going to pick up your work and change it, it's all up to us. This is just a simple hand-drawn leaf and it has been cut into a fawn shape. So basically what we do is, you take some strip of paper. Since in the leaf I want a center vein, I fold it and then you cut it. You can hand cut your own leaves. These are punches. These are paper punches. So you know, this is how you can create different shapes with just a piece of paper and any one color medium. Start with any one color medium that you have. And if I have to show you my leaf box, please excuse me, I didn't get time to clean up this box today. So these are all leaves from soft oriental paper. And this is a mixture of distressings and it is a mixture of archival inks. The variations that we do in embossing, what I wanted to show you all was actually that this leaf has been done line embossing from both the sides. Just, you know, using a ball tool. But some leaves have been done with the groove golf tool. So these are the leaves with the groove golf tool. So you can do both the types of embossing even on the leaves. Different types of embossing on the leaf. Your paper is really going to play a very important role in your final output. Now, anything else that is left from my side, I think from my paper, I have covered up selecting colors, selecting shapes, selecting paper, selecting the different embossing techniques, then selecting formation and arrangement. I'm coming to that now. So these are the last two things which are left for today's sessions. If you have any questions other than these two, then you can ask me. Because I know there are a lot of doubts which come for people who are into flower making. Somebody had asked me in between about the pollens. So you have a lot of tutorials on how to make the stamens. You take a wire, then what you will do is you take a cornstarch and you take a glue, you mix it well. Into that you put a little of a zinc oxide powder so that, you know, it remains white. And more than that, it is an insecticide. You do not get insects on it. And then you dip into it and you, you know, get these kind of pollens. You stiffen the thread and all. It's a long procedure. YouTube is the best to answer you for that. You want to see projects with what, Vishakha? I mean, which projects you want to see? I have some easy peasy projects with me. My floral oriental projects are the jewelry pieces right now with me. Let me go on to quickly now the flower formation. And then I will go on to the arrangement. So I'm just showing you, this is the flower that I created. This is the flower I created. I will show you how to bunch the stamens also. I will show you how to create a bead-headed pearl also. Somebody is asking me, how did the calyx look before? So let me open and show it to you. So this was a 3-petal die cut out. As I tell you, I rarely do hand cutting, though I love it. This is a 3-petal die. So as the bud becomes smaller, or as the flower goes from a big bloom shape to the buds, we go on, you know, having the calyx going smaller. So, you know, first you have the big bud, that is 5-petal, then 4-petal, and then 3-petal. Somebody wants me to color the leaves. Okay, I'll color one leaf and show it to you all. Let me pick up. I have a die cut out. I'll show you both. I'll show you on a colored paper and I'll show you on a white paper. That is a good thing. I'll show you all quickly and then I'll move on to the embossing. Final formation. So I have a green color paper and the best part is I have taken two green colors. One is dark and one is light. Also, I have one leaf. This is the white TK sheet. So let me show you all how to color this also. It's very easy to color white. It is very challenging to color the colored pieces. Right now I have distressings which are really very easy and handy to me. So let me pick up field paint, shabby shutters. Also let me take up some forest moss. Just give me 1 second. I'll quickly pick up this thing. It's falling on me. Okay, perfect. I'll also need a chip sapphire. Whenever you have to deepen the greens, you always use a blue. Never use a black or a brown. Brown can be used to create a different shade, but we don't use the blacks. We just avoid using the blacks. When you have to deepen the greens, you always use a blue. So if I have to show you how I'm going to use the blue, this is chipped sapphire. This green is dark, but still I want to color it. I want to add some more color to this. How am I going to do it? I have taken chipped sapphire. From the base I start. Can you see? Automatically I get 2 shades. Gorgeous. Beautiful. The lighter I move, the shade takes a little second tone. Again, I go only the second time on the lower base, I get a darker shade. So you get 3 shades of leaves. If I take the same color and apply only on the edges, then I get an outline. Leaf cutting is also an art. Oh, I don't mind. I will quickly show you all 1 or 2 leaves. Because the arrangement I'm not going to do much. I'm just going to show you all how to form the flowers. I don't want to get into that details, but I will try to give you 1 arrangement. Then I have this. Since this is a lighter base, I can first use the peeled paint. So let's pick up peeled paint. You can even take your pencil colors. As I showed you, I have done pencil coloring to this. Pehle yellow kiya, fir niche se light green kiya, fir center se dark green kiya, fir brown veins khiche. So there is a lot of detailing if you get into pencil colors. You can use oxides. Color mediums, you can use any. But that you need to do your trials. Keep doing your trials and keep doing your experiments. You will come to a result. Can you see? From the other side, I blend it, which is clean. I got a beautiful gradation. Now, I will not add the forest moss. I will add the chipped sapphire. There is already enough heavy color. And I will blend this from the bottom, the blue color. So what will happen is, once we were locked down, after I had some work for 1 week, thereafter I didn't know what to do. I started cleaning up my deep cleaning of my craft room, and I found all this. That is a time when I realized that these are the lives that should be done so people really understand a lot of things. So this is how you can see beautiful gradations in the leaves. Now if I have to color a white, it is easy, but it is equally challenging. So what I'll do is, first I'll take a light green. Always give one base coat to a white medium. If you are doing shabby shutters or green, give one base coat of green. If you are doing a pink flower petal, then you give a base pink coat to any petal, and then you do the second shade, whichever you wish to. So this is shabby shutters. Green one base coat I am giving, because I don't want the white to be seen right now since I am coloring it onto a leaf. This TK paper is a little glazy. Got it? Now we have peeled paint. From the bottom, I will come taking the peeled paint. Always dab the ink, remove the excess, rotate, and then go. So you don't get patches. I am moving up. So now this is going to the base shade of the paper which we had. Can you see? Now I will take forest moss in this, because that green color will play a role to make it darker, and then I will move on to the other. So now you take a forest moss and you color, and you see you get a beautiful another green. And to this, if you add a brown, I don't have a vintage photo right now, or else I would have shown you all. It looks all the more awesome. So you can actually see three different shades right now. Shabby Shutters, Field Paint, Forest Moss. To this, if I add very little of Chipped Sapphire, it's going to look all the more awesome. It's going to add some depth to the base of the leaf. Do very lightly and gently. Make sure your applicator is lifted up and don't press it. You know, by pressing you will get patches. I'm just rubbing very gently, and you can see you get beautiful gradation of the leaf. So this is how you can create beautiful colors in the leaves as well. And you can keep trying and experimenting your colors, and you can make beautiful things out of it. I did say I would be showing you all something, but I forgot. It's out of my head right now. To make your jewelries waterproof, the best is ultra thick embossing powder, or you can, you know, put in a thick layer of glossy accent. These are the two things which came to my mind, which you can do. But it is very difficult to do in the flower, which has got too many deep cuts and notches. It's not that easy. You need to have those kind of petals. So now I will show you all first the projects that I have made. This is my platter. It's ready. Only three flowers I have made. The remaining are just some extras which I had, and I just felt like finishing them off. They were in the box with me. So I thought, let me just use it, because I wanted to show you all some color combinations. Can you see, this is only two colors. These are complementary colors. So this is how you complete your one full arrangement, and pollens I have added here and there as fillers. I'll be posting the pictures of this so you all can see them more clearly. So this is the flower that I made using the TK sheet. This is the flower that I made using the cartridge sheet. The side fillers are all from Soft Oriental. I have not made those because I didn't have that much time. I could only manage to make the main flowers and this extra, because just wanted to show you all how different papers will work differently. This flower I made from the cartridge sheet. Shalini, you want to rob them all? You don't have to rob them. I'll send them all to you. I don't mind flaunting one ring. All those who are into exhibitions, all those who are into Rakhi selling, all those who are into, you know, any kind of envelope making, y'all can actually take advantage of this session, and you can create lots and lots. Lots and lots means lots and lots. I had made some one extra flower, so I can show you how beautifully you can make. Handmade paper jewelry is in trend right now, so you all can create wonders. This is just to show y'all how a single pastel color combination can look good. You know, I mean, I just love this because I'm a pastel person. I love these. I'll post pictures of all this in a very good close-up. I just made tags. I didn't have time to make so much. So I thought now I'll use them on the envelopes or cards somewhere or the other. These are the contrast. You know, I have a yellow also, or I have a pink also, and I have a little bit of the magenta also. But they are all in one family. This is called monochromatic. All are pinks, the main flowers. And then I have just fillers. Fillers are generally yellow, green. They look good. Arrangements on envelopes, I will post it. Right now, I don't have anything handy with me. So, you know, this also looks so beautiful. Perfect. Now, I will just quickly give you all a flower formation. Maybe we will have one session specially for the envelopes with Soft Oriental paper. I will plan out. And I will give you all how to do flower arrangements with the Soft Oriental paper. I'll make some flowers and I will keep it. This is a real very good long live session. It's almost 1.5 hours I've been talking, and I've kept you all busy. So I'm sure this session has helped you all in some form or the other. Make maximum use of all the tips, tricks and techniques that I have shown you all. And I want to see you all making. All those people who said yes, a big yes, and who have written yes, yes, yes for the live session, I'm sure you all must really make all these. Get started from tomorrow. Make your experiments. I'm just giving it a little shape. Somewhere I felt, Kate, you know, there was a plate on top of it and the shape got deformed. once it is dried, you can do all these things. My cardstock flowers, I don't know where have they gone. Oh, they are here. I'll show you. They are not very super wow, but I have just done my good trials and I will work on it. I am using right now the Fevicol SH and Fevicol SH cone. The tip has dried off. I work with the cones because it becomes really very easy for me. Right now I am using the soft embossing pad. So depending upon your utility, you use the pad that you require. So this is an alternate placement, very simple. I have not gone into too much of a detail of the placement. If you see, all my flowers are very simple, just 2-layer and 3-layer, and I try to use the same size. I'm not going too much in gradation also. Gradation and all, you can do it when you're doing some elaborated projects. So if you have to put a pollen in this, I will quickly show you all how to tie the pollen, as many of you all had sent me a message, ma'am, we want to know how to tie the pollen. You need a thread. Oh, this wire is bounded. These pollens don't come intact well. You know, you have to actually take one each and then place them together. That is how these pollens come. I won't take a big bunch. I'll just take a small bunch. I think I'm okay with this much, just to show y'all. Fold it in half. Let it be uneven. If it is too hazy, I mean too up and down, then try to balance it. You take the thread and uski gardan tight kar do, aise like this, you know, exactly on the neck. Rotate and pull. When you pull, the pollens open up and you give your this, you know, what is it called, this knot, which these flower people do, this people who make garlands, phool wala jo banata hai wo, perfect hai wo knot iske liye. So I just grab 2 or 3 knots and I close it out. I will cut it out. I cut off the extra thread as well. And earlier we used to cut it till the edge and then place it. But nowadays I have changed that method. So what I'll do is, I'll prick a hole, but I will use my perforating pad. I will never use my embossing pad and spoil it. I will take a perforating pad. Right now the petals are wet. In case if it shifts, kindly excuse. But otherwise, this is a very nice tool which will give you all the sizes of holes, and you know, it's so instant. Otherwise, these days I've started using that one hand punch. That is also very easy. So I will pass through this down. So what happens, the pollens get inside and very little around the circle, I will place this glue. And I'll pass through this pollen. Sometimes these pollens get rigid. Apply little glue and, you know, stiffen them. Oh, this has torn, but anyway, it'll get stuck. So can you see how beautifully the pollens went inside and it don't pop up? Many a times I see in the flowers, the pollens are popping up. So we will work out very neatly with this, you know. So this is how it is. You can add glossy, you can add glitter, and there is no end to this. This is a very, very long, talkative subject. But I hope I have covered up all the basic tips and I have shared the maximum what I could do. And I think you all should see me now. If you have any questions, I will answer you. Or else I think it is 11:30 and it's a real, real, real long time. So thank you so much, everyone. I can see so many people. I know you all are awake. You all must be tired also because you all have done so much of a work. But before you all go, I want to show you all some projects with easy peasy paper, and I want to show you all once again my jewelry. The tutorials I have released today. Today we have released the tutorial for project number 1. Day after tomorrow we will release the tutorial for project number 2. And we are launching it alternate day. And on Wednesday we will be launching the 3rd tutorial. The reason being, there is some technical issues in Google Drive. So I want to avoid those issues, and that is the reason why we have, you know, launching 111 tutorial. So all those who still wish to register, the registrations are open. And we are offering 10% off from Crafters Corner to all the students, those who have registered for this course. Today I have not been able to send the broadcast messages in the broadcast group to all the students. So if you all have started shopping or if you all want to shop, I will be sending you all the code number. Maybe right now I'll broadcast it or tomorrow morning I will broadcast it in the group. And I will just quickly show you all some projects with the easy peasy paper as well. So you learn to make, I mean, you understand what I'm trying to talk about, the different papers also too. What paper did you use to make a flower in your tray? The main papers were those different. The side were all those fillers, which I told you. So I will quickly give you all a glimpse of the flowers. So let me show you all. These are all soft oriental. Here there isn't much. This is a necklace. This is also a necklace. It's not open. This is also a necklace. This is also a necklace. All these are beautiful necklaces. And this is my favorite project. This is from Easy Peasy Paper. This was a wedding celebration course. And there were two projects of it. I'm sure many of you all know it. This was the peony flower that I showed you. I've used in this. So these are this is the beautiful bride frame. And we also have a groom frame. So this was a pair of two frames together. Very soon I won't be coming up with the tutorials for the whole projects, but I'm coming up very soon with the tutorials only for the flowers, individual flowers. If you all want to learn only roses, or if you all want to learn, say, only the peonies, or if you want to learn the chrysanthemums, or if you all want to learn the carnations. So these are those four flowers. Apart from that, I also have a few projects. This was almost, I think, 4 years back. So step by step, we will be launching all these courses in a different manner so that, you know, you all can learn it. This is the third project. There is one more project in the display. These are the cute little fingerings from Soft Oriental Paper. And this is the necklace. This is the part of the jewelry course. This is one necklace, the one that I am wearing. Girls, I don't have any groups. I don't have, because I can't handle groups. I have my broadcast is only for the students who have enrolled for the course. That's it. Otherwise, I don't have any groups. I post on Facebook, so you can follow me on Facebook. This is another frame with easy peasy flowers. This is the first jewelry that, you know, the part of three jewelries. Yes, Harsha, I'm coming up with this course. This was the jewelry that was taught at Creativation 2020, and it was a very big, big hit for the show. People had loved it. All the students had completed their projects in the class and everybody wore it, and they went and they had created beautiful roses. This was a big, big, big hit for the show, and people had really liked this so much. People had loved it. The last project is this. So this is all easy peasy flower projects, and this is what I wanted to show you all. You all want to learn that necklace which I had taught in Creativation 2020? Shalini is saying, please teach now. Oh, I would love to teach. I will teach. We will plan out a date. And we will post it, because the tutorials for the same are already ready. So I can, you know, anytime launch the tutorials. Time being, because we are not able to ship any kits, we will go for only tutorials right now. Maybe once the lockdown is open, we can start sending you all the kits. Any questions, any queries, you all can ask me, or maybe you can, you know, then later put it on the Facebook post or something like that. That is also fine. Okay, thank you so much. I am coming up with lots and lots of new courses. My heads are already up. My antennas have started working since the day I have started my cleaning. As I said, I have lots of flower making courses in small, small portions. There are a lot of doubts which people have, and I really wanted to clear all those doubts. So I'm coming up with very, very, very beautiful courses in flower making. They will all be, time being, only tutorials, because right now, until the lockdown ends, we cannot sell, we cannot give you all the kits. It's going to be a little very difficult to send you all the kits. So thank you so much, everyone. Thank you for being there. I know it's 1.5 hours I've been taking your time, but I have enjoyed this session thoroughly. because this was like I really wanted to give these details about the flower making to you all since a very long time, and I have been able to do it today. Thank you so much for being there. Thank you so much. Good night. Stay safe, stay home, stay indoors, and I'm waiting to see all your projects that you create very, very soon. And after this live session is over tomorrow, I'll be posting the course details also very soon, and I'll be posting you all with the new courses as well. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. The jewelry that I'm wearing is with the soft oriental paper. The jewelry which I have created is only with the soft oriental paper. And I have also given in my tutorials the different color mediums that you can use or the different papers that you can use to create this jewelry. So since whenever we create a project, we show you, you have seen something. So basically something has attracted you. So we have, in the tutorials, give you 100% first what we have actually used. Then later you can make your substitutes and you can change it. No problem. Once again, the comments are stuck up. I'm not able to read it. I don't know what was the matter today. I really just couldn't read the comments. But anyway, I have tried to pick up my major and I have answered you all. Thank you so much. Good night. Thank you.